I've dropped the egg. Or did I? Most of the crowd here tonight might think this is an accident that will create a big mess, and you'll start thinking about all the things that could go wrong. Or instead, you could look at this, as Tyson mentions in one of his speeches, as a science experiment. This could be a learning moment about Newton's laws, gravity, or even biology. It could be the moment you learn how to safely transfer such fragile objects, or the moment a child learns how the Smith turns into a chicken. We are all born scientists. Yes, you and me. We are scientists at heart. We are born with the innate desire to explore the mysteries of the universe, with a curiosity that helps us understand the world around us. This is proven by Jean Piaget's cognitive development theory. Piaget explains that since birth till the age of 2, we learn about the world through our senses and motor actions. In this very first developmental stage called the sensory motor stage, we touch, manipulate, look at, listen to, and even bite and chew objects. These actions are important for our cognitive development. These actions are the manifestation of the scientific method. See, the scientific method isn't just a couple of steps used by scientists in their labs. It is the way we perceive life itself. We are constantly, since birth, observing what's going on around us. These observations make us come up with so many questions. We try to come up with guesses, or what I prefer to call hypotheses, to answer these questions. We then proceed to test these hypotheses and collect data. Based on the data we collected, we come up with conclusions that shape our personalities, career path, and the way we understand life. Our learning journey proceeds by an interplay of adjusting new experiences to fit prior concepts and adjusting concepts to fit new experiences. So, the moment we stop ourselves from going through a new experience is the moment we stop learning and developing. Why do we stop though? Why do we, as we grow older, we become less and less explorers? We no longer jump in a puddle of mud, try a new sport, or even allow ourselves to take the wrong turn. It's because we are afraid. We are afraid of making a mistake. We are afraid of taking the wrong decision. We are afraid of failure. But little do we know that every mistake, every wrong decision, every failure is nothing but a crucial thread in the tapestry of our life. If we look at every mistake we've done, we get frustrated. But if we take a step back, we will see the most beautiful and colorful tapestry created. We realize then, every wrong step, every bad decision, is what shapes us to become the best versions of ourselves. We allow social constraints and people's perception to stop us from exploring our powers and unleashing our potential. It inhibits us from trying something new, taking a bold decision, or exploring the great opportunities the world has to offer. Yet, the only way to advance in life is by trying something new. Take those bold decisions, make those mistakes, and learn from them. This is why I am here tonight to remind you that the best way to live life is by unleashing the scientist in you. Thank you.